What are those voices? I know this place. I've been here before. I've been here my entire life. I'm trapped in here. These stairs. I'm climbing these stairs again. I need to get out. The voices are calling me. Music box. It's broken. I have to fix my old music box. I have to get it. I have to... Those horrible dreams again. I've had them repeatedly ever since my mother died and left me that music box in her will. Harry always said that old family heirloom had something to do with my family's strange disease. If the doctors won't give us an answer about your illness, I'll search for one myself, you said. And in that search, it seems you lost yourself. I don't think I'd ever...
Pardon me, madam, but the island is in sight. We'll be lowering the boat in just a minute.
Oh, thank you so much, Captain Hodgson. I'll be right out. All right. Time to gather my things. Captain Hodgson has a very particular taste when it comes to decor. I think I've overpacked. Up my hands before I leave the cabin. I wouldn't want anyone thinking I'm a circus freak. Ah, the amazing adventures of Norah Everhart, art teacher. After spending so much time reading this book, I think I've learned a thing or two about Polynesian culture. Oh, I love this song. I received a mysterious package at my house. I stored all its contents in my locked suitcase. Oh my, I have the worst memory. I forgot the combination again. Thank goodness I always bring my journal with me to write things down. Right, now it's open. This strange and sharp relic came in the package I received at home. Harry Everhart. My husband, my partner, and my dear old pal. Harry Everhart. My husband, my partner. I saw this island in one of my unsettling dreams.
I drew it as soon as I woke up.
A brass key with the letters CW engraved on it, and some enigmatic instructions.
We're all set, madam. The motor boat is ready.
Okay, Norah. From here on out, you're on your own.
Lower the motorboat. Be careful with Mrs. Everhart's equipment, lads. We'll be back to pick you up in 3 days. I really hope you find your husband there, madam.
I hope it too. I'll see you in 3 days then.
But please be careful on that island. You know what the legends say about it.
I'll take care. Thank you, Captain Hudson. Well, here I am, in the middle of the ocean after traveling across half the world. Just miles away from where my husband is supposed to be. You left a year ago to search for a cure for my affliction. Your letters kept me close to you, but suddenly they stopped coming. What happened, old pal? What did you find? Whatever it was, it led you to hire a crew and set sail from San Francisco to Tahiti. And from there, to this place. An island in the middle of the Pacific that the locals refuse to even name. Everything is familiar. So familiar. As impossible as that may sound. Is this the island I dreamed about? This can't be a coincidence. Idyllic island, surrounded by deadly reefs and protected with stakes to keep anybody from entering. Why? There's definitely something strange about this place. Okay, Harry. Let's see if I can find any trace of you around here. I'll leave my things in the boat until I find somewhere to camp. Feel quite good. I dare say I might even walk a little faster than usual.
Those markings seem to represent the sea. I'll make a note of them in my journal. It might come in handy. These wooden figures are called Unu. This seems to be telling a story. Peaceful, but clearly somebody wants to keep outsiders off this island. From what I've read, the Polynesians don't need doors. So why build such a big one? Well, that did something. Something's missing here. This box. CW. Those are the initials on the brass key. It opens it. So whoever sent me this key was here. This is starting to look like a scavenger hunt. A carving tool. Tent. So somebody was on this island recently. Well, that's a vivo, a flute that the Polynesians play with their nose. I want a miniature va'a, a Polynesian outrigger canoe. Beautifully crafted, too. A note written in French. I only understand two words, ill and mort, island and death. It must be a warning about the dangers of the island. Looks like it opens from the other side. Something's missing here. What a lovely flower offering. What a lovely flower offering. This is starting to look like a scavenger hunt. Well, look what's hidden here. It works. This may be the first time I trespass a private property. My childhood in Newburyport wasn't exactly the most thrilling thing. A mechanical bridge? That doesn't fit in with Polynesian traditions either. This reminds me of those slot machines that Harry and I saw at the Atlantic City Pier, but a Polynesian version. It's been years since I took such a long walk. This fresh air is doing me wonders. What a beautiful mountainous landscape. This sort of pond is a Polynesian fishing technique. There's another symbol inside it. A bone fish hook. rays of sunlight shining through. Another symbol. My, this is so beautiful. Oh, what were these birds called? Lorikeets. Cole's lorikeets. There are lorikeet feathers scattered around this unu. I'll draw the symbol in my journal. This looks like cargo from an earlier voyage, long before Harry's expedition. I can feel the air is denser here in this mangrove swamp. Well, I guess I hit the jackpot. That's my ticket across the river, then. Steady now.